This is Fly Guy. We're continuing on with our Star Wars The Black Series, The Last Jedi first wave of figures. We're looking at Kylo Ren here, yet another Kylo Ren for the line, obviously from the new movie. If you want a freeze frame, you can read the text there. It doesn't tell you anything you don't know. Nice drawing there by Gregory Titus, and quite a prominent scar on the figure there. You may not see it on that drawing there, but it's very prominent and very clear. It is not quite, however, on the figure, but we'll talk about that in just a minute. Number 45 in the wave. We'll get a look at him in just a sec. UPC, if you need it, is underneath. Hopefully that helps. In terms of height of this figure, I should have added if I didn't, just under 6 inches. And again, compared to the previous Kylo, really quite a difference in facial tone. The previous Kylo was a very pale colour. This is a much more skin colour, much better kind of colour on the skin. This here did have weathering, this one did not. So there's kind of wins and losses overall on each. Slightly different uniform overall, semantics I guess, but you can see one had kind of grid lines. This is a much more of a mesh, and his cape's quite different. Saber looks to be slightly different. The red here is a much more translucent, clearer colour. That is a solid and more solid plastic, dull colour. So really, I mean, it's small stuff, but there you go. You can see the belt on this one was done in silver, and this one's very subdued silver. But let's get a look at that really up close, and we'll show you a little bit of a comparison more shortly. So first of all, let's get that facial sculpt looked at, and as you can see there, pretty good likeness, I have to say. I think they've captured him really, really well. Bit too pinky in the lip gloss department, but not bad. It's not bad overall. Seems to be a little bit of glitter in the package under his eye. Maybe he's just trying to look fabulous for Rey. There's a little scar there, obviously, but it's so really non... you just don't really notice it. It blends in very well, and I think that might be just to do with the weathering on the face. I think I can understand Hasbro's perspective. If they didn't want to weather it too much, it would just look ridiculously big. But you can see it very clearly there once you begin to look up close. Again, the hair is all one colour. There does not appear to be any tonal shading. Actually, there is. There's a little bit of black. There's a little bit of black being applied to the figure on the hair. Very subdued indeed. It looks less kind of blow-dried than the previous version in the film. When he took that helmet off, and it was just this ridiculous blow-dried hair. It was like, what is it, the Bee Gees? So I'm glad we don't have BG Kylo anymore. Much more realistic. Taking this cape off for a second, it's a very nice fabric feeling plastic here. You can see all the kind of way it's tucked and folded and inside, and it fits him beautifully, really, really nicely. It sits upon the shoulders. Of course, all bad guys have to have capes. And you see the kind of folds and nips and tucks there. There's a very nice design on it overall, that kind of slight grid pattern you see overall, and they've really echoed it onto the cape. I felt it could have done with just a little bit more weathering to really accentuate that, because that would have really popped out and been really visible. In some of the stills, that cape is quite visible, visibly clear, these little markings. But hey-ho, this is what we get. Underneath, he's got his kind of mesh-like suit that you can see, that kind of... detail underneath, and again the belt, and kind of brown coloured pants, I guess, dark winey purpley coloured pants, and shiny black boots, which are very nicely detailed. Lots of buckles and bits and pieces going on there. So it's actually quite a nice figure. In terms of the hilt, he comes with an unlit version of the lightsaber, which does actually clip onto the side of his belt. I have it here somewhere, if I've not lost it by now. Let's use this one. It's very similar to this anyway. There's really no difference. But what you can do is on the back of the figure, just at this point here, plug that in. And it does actually go in. The new one does anyway. The only problem is as soon as you put the cape on and move them around, it falls off. So it's not really the best solution for it. But it does work. So what I've done with it, I do not know. It's so easy to lose these tiny things. Oh my goodness. Anyway, in terms of that lightsaber, you can see if I can just pop that out there, you can see the detail, hopefully. Come on, focus. There we go. So you get some nice kind of, I mean, it's obviously all red plastic, and they've then painted a little bit of red. You can just see on the hilt there, a little bit of red on the end. But again, the plastic's much more translucent and clear on the core part of the blade than it is on the two little side parts there. But nothing else really to report about it. Not that exciting. There was actually more detail in the previous one. The kind of gold on the hilt and other little bits of details there, which they haven't really added here. So, that's pretty much it. In terms of articulation on Kylo, we've got up at his non-blow-dried hair. Get this guy out of the way. It's causing the focus to go nuts. You've got a ball joint there. You don't have too much room you can maneuver there. You can see the joint, that little peg. You can move that far forward, but you can't really move back because, like a lot of villains, he has a mullet, and that's as far back as he can go, but still pretty reasonable. No real restrictions overall on the figure. Plenty of movement all the way around. No issues overall. Great joints at the elbows, I have to say. Again, think of the troopers. Here, this is what we get on the Force Awakens troopers. That's literally what you get. Here's what you get with Kylo. That's awesome. That's good at elbow articulation. It's not even a double joint. It's just that's what we need to do. So Hasbro, please, 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 please fix the First Order troopers and give us some good articulation, because that's what we need to hold guns and weapons and be in an action figure pose, is high up wrists like that, or high up joints like that. That's how far they need to go. Swivel kind of torso gives you a pretty free range of movement. That far back, that far forward, not too bad. Up at the joint, standard stuff. Peg up there, you get the swivel up at the top of the thighs, double joints at the knees. No boot cut, but you do get rocking ankles and pickles for those things that Hasbro never really give us very often. So, I do like this Kylo. Very articulated. He wears his cape very well and just looks kind of mean and moody and broody. You just get that kind of... I don't know how else to describe it, just a kind of spoilt brat face who then kills his father, I guess. It looks very good. If we can get this, see, you got to get under his mullet, you got the cape and the hair. There we go. So he looks pretty good, and he can hold great poses with the good articulation that he's got in this figure. So it's probably the best Kylo yet, I would say, without mask. I'd like to see another one with this new outfit with the mask on. I'm sure we're going to get it. Pretty good. Nice facial sculpt. Good figure to get. I don't think he's going to be too much of a peg warmer because he's going to be relatively popular. But let us know what you think. Leave a comment below on this Kylo Ren figure. It doesn't see anything other than Kylo Ren on the box, but we all know it's The Last Jedi. But let us know what you think of this new Kylo, and we'll see you for more Black Series figure reviews. Cheers!